Привет, all of you! My name is Эрдер the Fox, and welcome to the game called Protagonism. And this is the demo of the game that's gonna come out in 2021, I mean in the next year. I don't remember when exactly, but in the next year. And I thought that it looked pretty interesting. It's not a horror game, so don't worry. I mean, like, if you came here for a horror game, you might start worrying. But it's not. Well, you're gonna see. It's gonna be funny and dark. Dark, not horror, but dark is still kind of horror. You're gonna see, it's a very, very cool concept. Well, at least I thought so. We are playing as a narrator. Morgan was looking out of his bedroom window, contemplating his life in the suburbs. We can choose how we start. Morgan was watching a breaking news report on his phone. All the media outlets had been talking about the same thing, the tragedy. Even though it was evening, Morgan has just woken up and was laying in bed. Okay, how do you want to start the story? I mean, like, I think it's pretty cool because your playthrough... Oh, and this demo is free, by the way. It's gonna be so different from mine. So I hope you're gonna like it. Okay, I'm gonna go with my heart. He spent last night camping and found it absolutely fantastic. Thousands of shimmering stars, the rustling of the leaves, the smell of a campfire, the bear pee, not so much. Okay, the bear pee, not so much, huh? Great. He wanted to go back there again, but was too worried it would lose its charm if he did it too often. He would have to constantly invest into fancier camping gear, go deeper and deeper into the forest, start wearing those obnoxious camo pants, sell his house to buy an RV. Like a drug addict desperately trying to relieve his first high, or an athlete who peaked in high school. Suddenly Morgan exclaimed, "What the shit? Who said that?" He was very surprised to suddenly realize that there was a weird voice describing his actions. No shit, I'm surprised. What the hell do you mean you're narrating my actions? He was a very annoying person who kept trying to throw the story off its course, no matter how hard the narrator tried not to address Morgan directly. That would just be ridiculous, wouldn't it? Do you mind? I'm trying to narrate a video game here. I actually like the first one because it's sassier. Like... Okay, now, where was I? Ah, right. Oh, we can change that, even though it was evening. Oh, let's change, let's actually change that, let's not go with the same thing. Yeah, let's go with the breaking news report, because now we gave him, like, that's not what you said the first time. Surely I can't be doing two different things simultaneously. Could you please be more consistent in narrating my life? Really? I meant to say the right thing, guess making consistent stories is hard. I know, I wanted to see what would happen. Yeah, I know, I wanted to see what would happen, exactly. Could you stop trying to break the game, please? Well, I'm gonna think about it. I will play however I want. Are you absolutely sure you want to go down that road? Yes? I'm positive? Alright then. Here comes a personality test to check whether you are an idiot. Ready? Question... The first question. Are you an idiot? You don't give me an option here, but, like, yeah, you're kinda right about that. Question number two. Are you an idiot? Well, yeah, still nothing changed. Question number three. Are you an idiot? Well, nothing changed since the first two questions. Yeah, I got it. Oh, this is going for a while. I have admitted to being an idiot 10 times. I believe I have been punished enough. And this isn't fun anymore. I want to get back to the game. Yeah, that's what I feel. Yeah, that's true.
What just happened?
I think the developer of the game spoke to me.
Developer of the game? Are you delusional?
For freak's sake, my life is being narrated by a crazy person. Oh yeah, nobody wants to be in your place now, I'm sorry.
I'm crazy myself, aren't I?
Yep. No, I'm pretty sure you're just crazy, I'm sorry. You have voices in your head, man.
Oh, well, I better go get some professional help then.
I think that would be the most reasonable course of action.
Oh.
Protagonism. You've narrated the conclusion, do you think you're done? You've done your best. What? It's conclusion? No. No. Wait, my actions have consequences? Are you kidding me? Never heard of the word consequences. Pigeon, can you please?
What am I doing here?
Well, at least I didn't get Morgan killed, but like, of course, if you're asking your a voice in your head whether you are crazy.
Well, obviously not, right? Because you're not talking to yourself, you're talking to the voice in your head, right? 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 Guys, right?
0 out of 20 subpaths found.
Yeah, I guess I would be an idiot if I would go look for 20 subpaths.
Am I crazy? I don't think so. I mean, I know I exist. Let me try proving my existence and narrative powers to you.
Maybe you're right.
Your worries did affect my surroundings, but it might have been a coincidence.
Let's test this. Make me say something I would never say.
Morgan said something he would never say. Oh, that would be... У меня нету личной жизни, поэтому я занимаюсь всякой фигнёй. Например, я копирую текст из плохих игр в переводчик, а ещё у меня маленький хер. Okay, so that's Russian. I mean, it's written with English letters, but that's Russian. It says that I have no personal life. That's why I'm doing very meaningless stuff. For example, I copy the text from bad games into the translator. I guess because it was meant to be copied to the translator, but the translator wouldn't be able to translate this because it's written using. It's not written using the Russian letter, so translator wouldn't understand this probably. And moreover, I have a small PP energy. Yeah, small PP energy. Of course.
Is that Russian? Surely I could learn it at some point in the future. There's even a chance I could say this by making a random sounds for long enough.
You cannot! Don't compare Russian to random. Okay. Yeah. You can.
Not very convincing.
Morgan said, "Hi, I'm Gordon, and I don't know anyone named Morgan." Morgan mewed very, very loudly.
Clearly, the field that displays character's name says I'm Morgan.
Wait, you can see that? So you admit that you're aware of being in a game?
My birth certificate says I'm Morgan. What do you even mean, a game?
Oh. Morgan say, I drive a pickup truck and I have enormous PP energy, okay. Yes, darling, the dress does make you look fat. The end. Oh! No, I would never make him say that. No, never.
Because that's the word that starts with N. Never.
Okay. Yeah, go with that one.
Sounds personal. Did your parents body shame you as a child?
Oh, Morgan believed the narrator is the real deal. Holy freak, you are real!
Alright, regardless of how crazy this sounds, let's say I believe you. What now?
Well, let's see what options the dev is giving us. Morgan heard a knock on the door. Morgan did what all normal people do when the weather is nice, go for a walk.
And knock. Of course, knock on the door.
He opened the door and outside he saw... His girlfriend's parents nothing, so he closed it. Well, that's kinda lame. His parents. Gender neutral parent number one. Hello, sweetie.
Hello, sweetie. Gender neutral parent number one, gender neutral parent number two. What are you doing here? Is everything okay with gender neutral grandparent number four?
Yes, sweetie, we're all fine. Just checking in on you.
Yes, sweetie, we are all fine. Just checking in on you.
We heard about the explosion on the news.
And we're worried about you.
You should come home. I know, I just decided that gender neutral parent number one is really bad at pronouncing English words.
You'll be safer there with us.
Morgan found it endearing that even as an adult, his parents cared for him so much.
Cared so much, okay.
Oh, goddammit, it's not a fun option.
Everything's pretty peaceful here. I wouldn't worry too much. We should probably go.
Morgan! Will you walk us out to the car?
Of course!
Morgan went out the door with his parents.
Barefoot? I'm not a freaking hippie.
No, you did. Morgan, god damn it, I would make him. Morgan put on his shoes and went out the door with his parents because he wasn't a freaking hippie. They were halfway to the car when they noticed one of Morgan's neighbors looking up at the tree and seemingly talking to it. She seemed worried about something.
Sweetie, isn't that the girl you were telling us about?
You were right, she's very cute.
Why don't you help her?
We can walk the rest of the way by ourselves. Are you sure?
Go, lovebird, fly to your destiny.
Morgan's parents walked on towards their car while Morgan headed in the direction of the tree under which Story's love interest was standing.
Hi.
Hi, Morgan.
Are you talking to the tree?
I was heading out somewhere and my kitty somehow snuck out the door behind me. Now he's stuck all the way up there and I can't get him down. I tried luring him down with treats, yelling, sweet talking, even shaking the damn tree.
I don't know what's happening with my voice there. Have you tried calling the firefighters?
Oddly enough, they were busy fighting fires. Could you help me?
Damn fires! Those fires are freaked.
Morgan jumped up 5 meters in the air, did a double flip, a barrel roll, grabbed a branch, propelled himself up another 10 meters, detached his head, spun it on his finger like a basketball, put it back on, grabbed the kitty, and descended in a similarly impressive manner.
So there is a jump, there is the kitty. Wait, where is the head detachment? That was anticlimactic. Also, that's not how you spell anticlimactic.
Whatever, it will get fixed during proofreading. Okay.
Morgan, you're okay. You're scaring me so much. Never do that again. Never to touch your head again, please.
Never see your cat again?
Don't be silly. I was talking to the cat.
His name is Morgan, too.
Well, it's not, but I'm renaming him in honor of his savior.
Morgan the human found it cute. That will definitely get confusing.
It's the best I can do for a brave savior of cats!
Really? I don't think it's the best idea.
You can pout if you want. Morgan is a very cute name. And I'm not weird. I'm not creepy at all.
Are you hitting on me?
Maybe.
Actually hit him.
There is this club I've been meaning to check out for some time. Would you like to go?
Morgan gladly accepted the invitation.
Yeah, let's go! Why not?
That sounds lovely. What time were you thinking?
How does 7 p.m. sound?
7:24 right now.
What is typing?
What are you typing?
Oh my god! Stop building the suspense!
No, it's 7:32.
Nine then. I'll be there.
Sweet, see you.
Thank god it's not actually 7:32. I would get freaked out. Now, I just need to figure out how to get there.
Morgan took the subway, decided to drive. Okay, it's kinda interesting, but I wish there would be more action. Okay, let's proceed. Well, he did in the full version of the game, not in this demo though. Oh, I see. Aww. You have narrated the conclusion. That's it? Wait, that's it? What are you talking about? What do you mean that's it? Oh, so that's like literally a dead end. Oh, I shouldn't go clubbing. Okay, I see. So, the other option led us, right here, after a friend Fernando called. It led us to the exact same conclusion of a club. But there is like a bunch more stuff you could see. A night, different people, a group of people with a bat, and I think a chainsaw. I mean, it looks...
A dead people, what?
When does this part happen?
What?
Oh my god, there is something incredible happening over here, but unfortunately I'm all of the time for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, check out the game. I think the idea is pretty cool, but right now, because it's the demo, it lacks action. You see, one of the features of the game is that the game is self-aware. It's cool that the game is self-aware, but when you constantly put the same joke of nothing changing and like scenes being more boring than you would expect them to, yeah, it's funny the first time, you see, and then it gets kinda boring. So yeah, but the concept is still pretty cool. Please write down in the comments your opinion. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed the episode nonetheless. If you wanna see no more, the demo is free. It's just I'm out of time for this episode. So yeah, I encourage you to check it out because I feel like something very cool is happening over there. Look at that, there is like people fighting, there's dead corpses. I mean, looks like a fun place, right? And I'll see you next time. See ya!